Greetings to everybody, Kind of Games Online. Welcome back to more of The Legend of Zelda Ocarina of Time. You might have noticed I readjusted my audio levels, at least it should seem like that. If it doesn't, then I'm just acting like a fool, like I usually am. Last time, we got, well, after we came to the future, we looked around and saw what we could do. We got Epona as a rideable steed, if you will. We also got the hookshot, and we got start on the training sequence, which for now we have Kohiro. And this episode, it's gonna be some more cleanup. The Kokiri Forest, back here once again. Seems to be, yeah, that's a lot larger than the Deku Babas we know. And sure enough, it is a different enemy, as it'll draw three sets of Deku Nuts instead of just one. So the entire place has been basically infested with monsters, so that's gonna be a bit of a problem. But one thing you would want to do, now that we're here in the future, a lot of this episode is going to be like cleanup work for other side questing, so I will warn you of that now. But we'll try to make the next episode us starting the next dungeon. In any case, right here there's a gold sculpture. Now, you might recall, back in the past, we're going to refer to this as past and future for simplicity's sake. In the past, there was this. Ow. God damn it. Every time. But we can ride this around, this magic bean plant, and hopefully it'll lead us somewhere useful. As I recall, though, this one is one of the less important ones. It does not lead us to a heart piece or a gold sculpture or anything like that. So, don't worry about going after this one. Because, yeah, this is the main reward. Get all that money, which, money is still money, so I'm not going to say no to it. But, it's like, there's more important ones out there. As we saw in the last episode, when we went to get the hookshot, we saw one of the magic beam points that we made, which ended up getting us a heart piece. But I digress. Let's just head on over to the Lost Woods. I think that's going to be the next place we want to go. And it also feels weird because it's actually been a few days. Like, I record these usually in bunches, like these episodes. I record them in sections. And it's been a few days since I recorded, like, I don't even know when the last time I recorded was, but then again, when do I know anything? This magic beam point, its main thing is to form a shortcut so you can just jump onto the bridge over there. And you can use that as a slight shortcut. More speedrun effective, but out of all the beams, I think these two that we just showed off are probably the least useful. It's ironic that I say that, because I'm probably going to be using it right about now. Kohiro, why? Normally only a nice guy like me can tame you. Which means, you must be a nice guy. Must be. You must be. Please, Mr. Nice Guy, please. Deliver this stuff to the old hag in the potion shop in Kakariko Village. This will disappear if you take too long, so you gotta hurry. Let's do it. We get the odd mushroom. A fresh mushroom like this is sure to spoil quickly. Take it to the Kakariko Potion Shop, quickly. It is as they say, you have 3 minutes on the clock, and you have to take this to Kakariko Village as fast as you can. And I'm gonna say this now, for these timed sections, there's something that you can use that will allow you to get around the area faster. You can't use that during these sections. People who played this game before probably know what I'm referring to. In fact, we're going to get one just before the first dungeon. Or by first dungeon, I mean first adult dungeon. First future dungeon. But that shortcut that we made is going to make things a lot quicker. So, get that and you'll be fine. Technically, we can complete the entirety of the training sequence before entering the first dungeon. But I don't want to really do that because it's just going to be like, we got to do a lot of crazy stuff. And the item that we get in the first dungeon is going to help us immensely. Okay, well, maybe not immensely, maybe only moderately, but it's still gonna help us with the trading sequence, namely for the end of the trading sequence. So, I'm not gonna be too worried about the entirety of the trading sequence yet. But, where you need to go, is actually somewhere we haven't been before in Kakariko Village. Because, now that it's the future, there is a potion shop here. There's a pathway back here. So this is how we can get back into this area. If you remember, we had to come here when we were getting the 7 cuckoos in the past time. And this is where we need to go. What a mysterious smell. You must have something. Show it to you. That bum. He had to go into the forest. I see. Hey, give it to me now. The screen's gotten dark! You see that fool? Give this to him. It is the strongest medicine I've ever produced. However, this potion will not work on a monster. You get the odd potion. You don't know what's going on between this lady and that guy, but take it to the Lost Woods. They say that there is no medicine that can cure a fool. I guess that's true. Alright then. Now we gotta head back to the Kokiri Forest. Once again, back to the Lost Woods. And for simplicity's sake, I'll see you when I get there. Alrighty, we're back here in the Lost Woods. So, we move on forward. Guess who's back? What are you? Though you wear Kokiri-ish clothing, you can't fool me. I promise sorry I would never let anybody go through here. Well then. If I can... I gotta remember the song. Now this'll prove to you our connection with Saria. That melody. Saria plays that song all the time. You... Do you know Saria? That song. Saria taught that song only to her friends. Okay, I trust you. When I see you, I don't know why, but I remember him. We now have access through here. And if we go over here, you might remember this place. Now, this bean sprout has grown. We've got yet another golden sculpture. And fortunately, since we have tools in the future, or the tools of the future, we have a sword that's more powerful. The Master Sword does do twice as much damage, so gold sculpture is dying one hit to it. Same deal for the hookshot. When we get something that replaces the slingshot, which we'll be getting soon enough, that also does double damage. So basically, anything you got in the past, the version of it you get in the future is going to be doing double damage. From here on, we'll be going through some narrow passages. If you take it slow, maybe you can sneak up on some enemies. Use Z-targeting to always look in the proper direction. Set your view so you can see down the next corridor before you turn a corner. Once your view is set, hold down Z to sidestep around the corner. That way, you won't be surprised by an enemy waiting in ambush. So, if we look around here by positioning the camera correctly, we have moblins riding around. These things, if they see you or hear you, then they're gonna charge at you. So you want to be very, very quiet. Fortunately, as we will see if once this guy walks on past, excuse me, they die in one hit. So if you see any, you might as well kill them. So they're not a problem for you, you have to backtrack. They will, of course, respawn if you leave the area and come back. Okay, we're fast. Alright. So this is basically the closest you're gonna get to stuff. Oh, god dang it. I was gonna see if I could use my hookshot on him. What an asshole. Okay, do your thing. I'm gonna run forward into this alcove. Now, can I use my hookshot on you? Yes, I can. I actually didn't know that. Well, the more you know. Cool. Alright, so what's... Alright, you douche. Alright, come here. You're dead. Alright, go this way. There's probably another one waiting around here somewhere. Oh, maybe not. Really? I can't actually go until he moves. And that's the problem here. Okay, he's moving. Now I'm gonna just sneak past you. And do that, and you're dead. Sweet. Now. Is that the last one? Yep. Alright, we are good to go then. But there's one other thing I want to get done really quick. If we go up here... Uh-oh. Oh, no. Okay, that's not a big deal, actually. I just gotta kill that guy. But as I was trying to do... If we go over here... And actually, with how close we are to the next dungeon, we might even be able to start it in this episode. So I don't plan to... to do much more in side quests. In fact, this is the last thing I'm going to do for side quests. Yet another gold sculpture token. Which puts us at 48. Two more we can get claim our next reward. And in fact, we have all the gold sculpture tokens in the Kokiri Forest and the Lost Woods. So we are done in that department. Alright, we're not going to be needing our side quest item for the time being, so I'm just going to replace it with I guess, bombs. But here, we've got a larger moblin. He's gonna swing down his club, and if you get caught in the shockwave, you're getting knocked back very far. Well, not very far, but like at the start of this big moblin section. On the plus side, if you kill him, he drops quite a bit of money, or at least enough to top off my money. So we head up here. Flow of time is always cruel. Its speed seems different for each person, but no one can change it. A thing that doesn't change with time is a memory of younger days. In order to come back here again, play the minute of forest. You have learned the minute of forest. Link, I'll see you again. Now that is done, it's time to enter the next dungeon. We're actually not going to make it that far into the dungeon, but... The Minute Forest, in fact, a lot of songs we're going to learn in the future. I'll actually show here. See this symbol right here? This symbol that I'm hitting my hookshot with? If we play the Minute Forest, we will return onto that symbol, so it helps for our travel. This is basically equivalent to, say, the Song of Soaring or Ballad of Gales in future Zelda games. But, welcome to the Forest Temple. Probably one of my favorite songs out of the dungeon themes in this game. We're gonna open up with some Wolvos, which their strategy is still the same. Hit them in the back, they die in one hit. You might not remember Wolvos because we fought them only once, I believe, in this adventure so far. Now we've defeated three in total. This is also gonna be interesting because I don't remember the adult part of the game as well as I do the child part, namely the gold sculpture tokens. I see one over there, so we might as well get that one knocked out while we're still thinking about it. Alright, good. And we had to come up here anyways, because we jumped to this branch. We get a small key. Don't spend it all in one place. Which, now that we're actually in the adult dungeons, we're going to be seeing small keys a lot more. The only case we've seen of them in the past was when we actually attempted that treasure box minigame, and that's about it. But we head in here. This room is essentially the central hub for this dungeon. And it's also going to introduce us into the gimmick of this dungeon. In total, there are 4 Poes throughout this dungeon. We need to find and defeat every last one of them if we want to get to the end of the dungeon. We're probably not going to make much progress in that in this episode, but we'll probably make some progress in that in the next episode. Over here, there's yet another Gold Skulltua token. Alright, we're probably... This might end up being the last room we clear, not this room, because it's just a hall room. Oh, these things! Bubbles! You got a protective shield around them, so just hit them with your hookshot, and then stab them. Of course, their shortness doesn't really help me when it comes to stabbing them. And here, we have another new enemy. We have... Stalfos. Stalfos, they have a shield that they can put up to defend against you with, but basically when they slash or when they jump slash or anything like that, that's your best time to attack them. So now if you may be so kind as to slash me, you have a shield too, you know. Now die. Just die. Okay. Both of them are gone. It's really gruesome how it's like you kill them and they just break off into a ton of... If you break up, well, I guess they're kind of a skeleton, so maybe not entirely gruesome, but I don't know. Maybe I'm crazy. Actually, no, like that's exactly what it is. In any case, we have a second small key, so if we use one, we'll at least have another. So, I think with all that done, we are good to end off this episode. We continue more into the training sequence. We got some more Gold Skulltuas. We got the Minuta Forest, so we can easily get back to the Star of the Forest Temple whenever we need to. And we will enter the Forest Temple and start looking around to see what there is. Next time on The Legend of Zelda, Ocarina of Time, we're going to be exploring further into the Forest Temple in hopes that we'll find these Poes. See you guys! Then...